Namaste and hello to one and all who has joined live with Maja Samrajya. Happy Independence Day to one and all. But let me tell you, 15 August is a day of double celebration for Maja Samrajya, as on this day Maja Samrajya was inaugurated. And today we are celebrating its first anniversary. And on this occasion, I'm really privileged to have the pleasant task of welcoming our today's guest speaker, who's going to speak on the topic, Why People Suicide, a Spiritual Perspective by a Spiritual Mentor. Yes, we are having with us a spiritual mentor who is also the founder director of the Disha Group, Dr. Shibani Kasula.
Namaste.
I welcome you, ma'am, on behalf of Maja Samrajya family.
Thank you, Faryal. And I want to wish everybody a very, very happy Independence Day and a very happy birthday to Maja Samrajya.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, how can you explain spirituality in your words?
So we directly start with our conversation, right?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Fantastic. So I think this is a very good question to start with, Faryal, because many of us think spirituality is all about taking a jhola, becoming a yogi, and just about leaving everything and living like a sadhu sang. But I should say it is exactly the opposite of what we think. In simple words, it is a lifestyle. Yes, for me, that is what has changed in my life. A lifestyle makeover. That's it. As simple as that. A very sorted out kind of a lifestyle, you can say. Because it just changes your entire perspective about looking at people, looking at situations, issues in your life. You become more sorted off, kind of. Your thinking is streamlined because you start becoming more and more non-judgmental, not only about others, but also about your own self. Your trust rises up to a different vibrational frequency. You start trusting your own self and others, and moreover, the guidance that you keep getting all the time. And this takes your thought process to a different level altogether. And the best thing is, everything about you is absolutely taken care of. I am experiencing that every moment of my life. I hope I have covered everything that I know and feel about spirituality that I'm experiencing myself. Believe me, it's a beautiful, peaceful, and a very, very assertive lifestyle you can always adopt. Yeah?
Ma'am, leaving your corporate life, what made you choose this path of spiritual mentoring?
I always love to address this question, especially when it is asked by youngsters like you, Faryal.
Yes, ma'am.
Like everybody, I had all my dreams streamlined after finishing my post-graduation from one of the topmost B schools of India. I never connected to my corporate work. I always felt very much out of place there. Then marriage happened and a new life started. You know, actually in every healer's life or a spiritual person's life, there has to be something happening so drastically that the complete perspective, their complete presence is shaken. But for me, nothing like this happened. It was just that my first pregnancy gave me all the time I needed to be with myself and actually explore my inner conscious. And while doing so, I felt very inclined to learn astrology from my first guru, my dad. And least did I know that that was the moment I actually entered this beautiful world of occult, which I was actually destined to work for. And that was actually my sole purpose. And then the real adventurous journey of my soul began. I was all guided every step to learn all that I needed to take up on this path of mine. a lot revealed from my past lives and from my lives, which will be still there coming. I'm awaiting. And then I started joining the dots of whatever I was seeing and feeling. So now you tell me which corporate life could give me that kind of a satisfaction, or rather I will say that kind of a bliss that I was getting in this work of mine. It's like when you know why you have taken a human birth, the reason for what you are here, that's it. I guess then no other work will ever appeal to you. I actually started, you know, feeling very much at home when I started doing my work at the right place. I felt absolutely very peaceful. And moreover, I was actually using my management skills to build my network and take Disha globally. And today, Disha is placed all over in Southeast Asia, UK, Africa. So I guess I never actually left the corporate world. My work defines my perspective and my mind. And Disha has no boundaries. We go anywhere and everywhere spreading our work, connecting to beautiful people like you. Believe me, this spiritual networking now is absolutely amazing. We just don't need any Wi-Fis. We are simply just connected. I'm sure all my Dishites who are listening to this 100% agree with me. Yeah, that's what is my journey.
That's really great, ma'am. Ma'am, what is the connection between spirituality and horoscope?
Yeah, very deep indeed. So, what are horoscopes? For me, horoscopes are the blueprints of the planetary positioning at the time of our birth. Okay, so these planets are always in transit, and so we feel things happening in our lives. Life is moving, a lot of issues happen in our lives, right? But I strongly believe that there is something which is much, much more beyond planets, you know, which only a tuned soul can see, analyze, and guide you rightly. And that tuning into the universe is the connection between astrology and spirituality, the horoscopes and spirituality. Not only your present life, but also if the astrologer is again tuned into the universe, he can see your past, your present, your future with a very psychic kind of a perspective and then rightly guide you. So you should be very, very, very careful whom you are approaching with your soul's blueprint. If you are in the right hands, you are through. Otherwise, you will be caught up in such a mirage kind of a situation, completely bhul-bhulaiya, and instead of offloading and finishing the unfinished stuff you have come for, you have taken birth for on this earth, you will be actually adding onto it your baggage. So it is that deep a connection between spirituality, astrology, that is your horoscopes.
So ma'am, can suicide be predicted by horoscopes?
Can you repeat the question?
Can suicide be predicted by horoscopes?
Yeah, now see, when a person approaches for a horoscope reading, he either comes in with a very clear aura or an affected aura and a baggage that you've come down to this earth for. Unfinished baggages. Now, suicide is something which is very, very deep rooted. It may be a conscious decision to end your life or unknowingly, you know, a forced one. Now, technically speaking, in a horoscope, yes, we can 90% of the times predict suicides. Seeing the planets in the 6th, 8th, and 12th houses, which are the malefic and inauspicious houses of your horoscope. The third house from birth Mercury shows where your thoughts actually are looping, you know, the repeat again and again. Death is death, can be seen from the eighth house, which is the Mrityu Sthan of a horoscope. And the timing of the death can be seen from the lords of the second and the seventh houses. So there are many, many more permutations and combinations of the planets, of the Rashis, of the Mahadashas, where you can actually predict suicides. You know, our astrology is a very, very deep-rooted science, occult science. If you are in the right hands, you are sorted out. But again, this is the technical way of looking at it. You know, looking at horoscopes, very technical way. But how do you explain a death of a person wherein the horoscope, it shows he has a very long life and then he's just gone. He's just dead.
Yeah.
Now, I have had many such incidences which I have termed as the contradictions to horoscopes. And again here, the deep roots of astrology are connected to spirituality. Because only predicting will not work then. You know, you actually need to help that person come out of that thought process, that negative thought process, change his entire perspective about looking at life. And then you have actually achieved or done something, you know, for that person. That is very important. So that is not only, you know, the way or only the horoscopes, just predicting through planets will not help you. The astrologer has to be really tuned in, you know, and he should be able to see beyond horoscopes. 90% of the times, I have seen suicides are connected to past lives and also the energies and the surrounding atmosphere that you are. I'm not talking about the virtual atmosphere. I'm talking about the energetic atmosphere that you have, you know. So that way, horoscopes and suicides are connected.
Okay. Ma'am, can Vastu of a house be the reason or contribute to suicidal thoughts?
Now, this, actually this, Vastu, when we talk of, you know, I immediately start thinking of those Ramsey movies that we've seen. But though the Hollywood ones are quite realistic, the Conjuring kind of, if you guys have seen it.
Yes.
Based on real life stories and, you know. So, yes, Vastu can be one factor where energy is there. Could affect the thought process of a person. He can be compelled to do so. As I said earlier, it could be a conscious or unknowingly forceful decision to end life. Yeah?
Yeah.
See, we don't know what has happened in that land where our home is, right? Whether there are bones underground, below the earth, or any particular incident has happened there, or whether it's the ancestors of the land or the ancestors of the family itself. You know, as we say our pitters, right? Could be anything. And the person can go into depression due to these energies. Yes, but again, if the aura of that person is open or perforated, then it is very easier for your surrounding energies to get over you. That's why, you know, in spiritual practices, we always talk about aura being very intact. The spiritual protection kind of something that we talk about. So these energies which are there can be actually found out and dealt with various methods. There are methods of doing it. So Vastu energies should be definitely compliant to be in the right space mentally and physically, okay? Very peacefully to live in that abode whether it's your office, your shop, your homes, wherever, you know. And so, again, the connection between your vastu and spirituality.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I am not talking about getting your saral vastu fixed. I am not talking about your directions, your north, south, east, west, calling a vastu tadnya and getting your vastu entirely fixed properly. I'm not talking about the directions. That can be handled easily because when it comes to saral vastu, we have fixed remedies for that, for fixing the directions and the problems in the vastu as per saral vastu. But I am talking about correcting and repairing the vastu energies and vibrations of your space. Mane, the kind of energies, like at the entrance, if you have a loss vibration or an unhealthy vibration or a spirits vibration or something like a prosperity vibration, but that vibration is just 12%, 13%, 20%. Vibration, friendly vibration is very less, then there'll be a lot of fights in that house. If there are no peaceful vibrations, then again there'll be kalesh in the house. There'll be a lot of issues, financial loss vibrations will be there. There'll be a lot of losses in the house. So these vibrations in your vastu, whether it is the entrance of your vastu or the brahmasthan of your vastu, the vibrations have to be corrected. And then you do your saral vastu, it will give you fantastic results. So this way, the energies of the vastu affect your mental health.
Black magic and suicide. How is it, how these two concepts are connected with each other?
See, the way positive prevails, the same way negative also prevails. Jahan black hai, white bhi hai. Right?
Yeah.
And the law of the universe, what you give comes back to you. We all know about this, right?
Yes.
But talking about black magic and all is such a taboo in our society. You know, people are either scared to talk about it or they feel it is sheer nonsense and all bakwas. Talk about it. That's what they feel. So this topic is very less addressed. Could be also because people are made fool of. That also could be a reason. But yeah. First of all, black magic or white magic, these are all Puratan Vidyas. Which are Vidyas and which prevail. Like I said, the black and the white, both are there. Positive and negative, both are there. And it is the energy which cannot be destroyed. You know, energy cannot be destroyed, right? Our science, our father science says that, no? So, it is not easy to practice these Vidyas. Any Tom, Dick and Harry cannot get up and say ki haan maine black magic kar diya. Nindu mirchi karne se black magic nahi hota hai. And if at all it is sincerely done only, it really affects. It's the thoughts of that person that affect and the energies involved, you know, to do and carry out these practices could be compelling. So much so that the person takes an extreme step. Or could also be a backfire of deeds done by somebody from your family who is connected to you. So it works either ways. So yes, it is again a play of energies. You believe it or you don't believe it, energy prevails. It cannot be destroyed. Yes, Pariyal.
Yes. Ma'am, 2020 has been this 0 year with the pandemic still prevailing. And suicide, and the most talk about is Sushant Singh Rajput case. So what is your take on it?
Oh my God, this poor soul of Sushant.
Yeah.
God knows, you know, how many tried to connect with him.
Yeah.
You, bhai, who asked you to connect to Sushant's soul? Did his blood relations come approach you to do so? What all nonsense and crap is going on social media, you know?
Yeah.
Everybody just connects and you have a machine and then you hear Sushant's voice. What nonsense, yeah. Is it so easy to just connect to souls like this? Agar usko connect hona hai na, to he will definitely, you know, now his world is different. Their world is completely different now. He's not on this 3D plane with us. And they just know whom to approach and how to get things done. The souls know it. And such unnatural death, souls generally keep lingering around. Either to get their desires at that time of death fulfilled and then get into the light or carry on their journey ahead. Or they are just stuck in the middle world until help reaches them. So just let Sushant be. Let whatever is happening in this 3D world happen. Apna jo chal raha hai na, investigations and all that. Who knows, his soul might just guide the CBI to reveal what happened with him. So general public, please just stop bullying his soul now. Sincerely, yaar. And this year, 2020, is the year of number 4. And 4 is the number of the shadow planet Rahu. Rahu made its transit in Gemini at the beginning of 2020, and will be here till 23rd September 2020. So it all, you know, will again transit from 23rd September from Gemini to Taurus. The planet Rahu affects lives of all the natives of all zodiac signs in this way now. That is why we all are caught up in one situation, right?
Yeah.
We are caught up in this pandemic. And so there is, because of Rahu, Rahu creates a lot of ambiguity, confusion, depression, a lot of emotional imbalances. You know, these are all the Rahu effects. We are all experiencing that, no? And it's like a full-blown psychological pandemic types.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah? And almost 300 or more than 300 non-coronavirus deaths reported in India. Majorly suicides due to distress triggered by lockdown. And a couple of them happened in the same premises also in AIIMS in Delhi. After Sushant's suicide, we had almost 8 youngsters suiciding. It's like so infectious kind of, you know, the suicides are so infectious. It's like a death tandem around us. And it's very natural for a normal person, you know, to be impacted mentally, emotionally. And again, that is why spirituality, which will make you more weathered and sustainable, absolutely very peaceful from inside. Because it's all about sustainability, you know, now?
Yeah,
just about sustainability. Agar zinda rahenge, तो जॉब पे जाएंगे तो बाकी सब करेंगे, है ना?
Yeah.
So it's all about
जाने तो जहाने.
Exactly. सर सलामत तो पगड़ी 50 बोलते हैं ना. So it's all about sustaining yourself right now in these situations, keeping yourself intact. If you think you can do it peacefully without getting affected by the surroundings, then you're already there. Mark my words, huh?
Yes,
if not, then you really need to uplift yourself, uplift your vibrations. Okay?
So, ma'am, how can one uplift their vibrations?
See, now let me tell you in our own current language. See, to be connected on social media, what do we do? We have mediums like Facebook, WhatsApp, Insta, our cell phones, blog and Twitter and all that, right? That is the way we are connected, no?
Yeah.
So in the same way, as individuals, we have our own ways to connect to our innermost selves, our own individual ways. And that cannot be taught. You need to identify this on your own. okay, every person has a different way to uplift his vibrations. Some can simply do it by meditations, some do it by yoga, some through painting. I also do it through cooking at times. Some do it through healing, practicing Reiki, pranic, all quantum healing kind of healings and all. Some just do their namasmaran, namjap, they uplift their vibes. The only thing is, do we really think about uplifting our vibrations at that time? When we are doing our choice of activity, we don't think that. We just do it because we feel good, right? So from now, consciously put intention to uplift your vibrational frequency, to uplift your energies in all those activities you enjoy doing. And you see how your vibrations rise. You will actually start feeling it. You know, it is as good as doing an intense meditation. So you don't have to actually sit and meditate. Whatever the best you enjoy doing, just put intention that I'm doing this. I need my energies to be uplifted. See, this coronavirus also has a vibrational frequency. Okay. And it is affecting us because we are also vibrating there, or rather vibrating low. If by doing all these practices, yoga, meditation, or what the way I told you right now, you uplift your vibrations above the frequency of the coronavirus, then that's it. It cannot attack you. You got it?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
That is the way. That's why we teach a lot of energy protections and all in this entire pandemic time, entire lockdown time. We've been doing a lot of Zoom sessions and all. And we've been teaching how to protect your aura, keep your energies intact. You know, we've been doing a lot of these things. And if you wish to learn more about how to raise your vibrations, you can connect with us. We technically impart training programs to do so.
Yeah, definitely, ma'am. Many people have joined us live, so even they are listening to you. So if anyone needs, they can connect with ma'am.
Yeah. Yes.
Ma'am, any message that you would like to give today?
You know, this pandemic has hit into the emotional layers of people. We say, no, that humans shape nature, but 2020 made us experience that nature also shapes humans.
Yes.
We are so helpless today. The universe has actually made a conducive space right now for us to experience what surrender is, because we are completely helpless. We have nothing to do other than surrender ourselves. So some of us did experience that surrender, and some of us kept cribbing and wasted our time. Today, on this beautiful day of our independence, I appeal to you all, since our topic of discussion has been suicide. See, we are in a place where we have the power to communicate with each other. And if anybody you know is sharing their thoughts, which you feel are weirdo, and they are expressing suicidal thoughts in front of you, then please take it seriously. Don't make fun of that person. Generally, people do express it. It's only that we don't take it seriously. We take it very lightly. We just make fun of them. Okay? So, be alert. Just believe them. They just need that confidence that time. Okay? And please approach for help immediately. As soon as you start feeling, that there's something wrong with this person, please approach for help to your psychiatrist, to your healers, whomever. And I also appeal to the media to stop all focus on all the masala and the TRP rating kind of stuff that they do after such suicidal deaths happen and take more responsibility on highlighting how they can help people out of depression and suicidal tendencies. You know, you guys really, the media really has so much reach from youngest to the oldest. So media should promote more awareness programs and help people uplift their lifestyles, not glamorously, but spiritually. So this is what I wanted to, you know, say, but I also wanted to put in my very strong intentions today through this very happening and beautiful platform of Maze Samrajya to help us all Bharatiyas uplift our lifestyles to the next level, the spiritual level, as we all in Disha believe that we need to jump from being human to being spiritual now. So this is the message I need to give to my fellow Indians.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for connecting with us. I'm immensely thankful that you're spending time with us. And I'm thankful to all the audience who has joined us. Like, your spiritual words has really have an impact on us. And definitely, we pray that suicide people move far from suicide and take help if they need. Thank you so much, ma'am, for being with us today.
Thanks, Pariyal. And I loved being, on this platform. And a lot of congratulations and abundance to Maze Samrajya, Prashant Sagvikar, Sakshi Sagvikar. I would love to see you guys growing. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you. Jai Maharashtra.